Here are the Lions now as they line up and kick this one away.
Hell yeah, my DBs cannot hang with them niggas, bro. I ain't even gonna lie. It wasn't even that much of my defense. I was throwing a lot of picks, but that D-line, bro. I don't know why they overrated Jai Randall and them niggas like that. Nigga, not like that.
Off the play fake, Wilson. And it's incomplete. Boy, he doesn't drop anything like that one.
That nigga, bro. All his other D-line did good, bro, but him, bro, he was right there every play. Every play, bro. And then he did a little DB blitz that was getting him too. I definitely wasn't. I couldn't do none of that blitz. So I gotta add a couple plays in there, bro. A couple dump balls.
And Sanders has got it complete on the move past the 40. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30.
Yeah.
The catch and run good for 24 yards. But it's almost as if they didn't leave.
Yeah, that's how, well, that's what my playbook says, bro. But I'm about to start doing it, bro. Because, I mean, during the playoffs and shit, that's what I'm going to have to do.
On first down, far. Pressure comes. He's taken down by the Seahawks defense.
It's just if I have time, bro, my plays would be cool. It's just when you don't give me that time, that shit would definitely backfire.
Now Favre. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
They let that D-line get crazy on the next gen, bro. You ain't got edge protector? It don't matter how good your lineman is, bro, on the edge. Slow.
Looking deep for Adams.
Oh my goodness. Thanks for Tay Adams though, Defoe. I needed him, bro. That Devin Hester shit, he was not getting open.
Any team wanting to give a player like this up in a trade, but I know they're happy to have him.
It is amazing, isn't it? But we have seen big time guys change teams. Jimmy Graham, Brandon Marshall, and their new teams are really excited to have them because they provide a big time target.
And in for the Lions touchdown. A great effort there. His second touchdown on the season. And the Lions have taken a 13-0 first quarter lead. Extra point splits the uprights, and that'll make the score 14-0. Here are the Lions now as they line up and kick this one away. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And they're in an early hole. First drive, they threw the interception. That led to a touchdown. So, decent-sized deficit early on.
It is, but I think you hit the key words, early on. So, they have to decide, do we even need to change game plan? Or do we just need to execute better and try and get back in this game?
So, the big play gets him across midfield now.
Why is this nigga Elliott in?
Wilson. Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Ifeatu Melifonwu. Try! And the Lions are going to take possession.
My nigga injured or something? Why the fuck is this nigga in?
There's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. Up the middle they go with Sanders. He's going to get four out of this as he's down to the 10-yard line. 14-0 the score. This is the NFL on EA Sports. Second and six from the 10. They'll run here with Sims. And running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there, so they're left with a third down and six.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
They haven't made much of this great starting field position they had. Here's third and six. From the shotgun, it's Favre. Left side here to Sanders. Touchdown! From 10 yards out, and the Lions take a three-touchdown lead. Point after, right down the middle, and that makes the score 21-0. Here are the Lions now as they line up and kick this one away. Oh, a mistake there. The kickoff out of bounds. So now the possession will begin at the 35 after the errant kickoff.
Well, that's certainly one way to avoid a dangerous kick return, I suppose, but you are giving up extra yardage, that's for sure. Because if you put it out of the end zone, they start at the 25. So at a minimum, you're giving up 10 yards to the offense.
And look at this. They come right back with a big shot downfield. And they're able to work this to the 25 before it's all said and done. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Here's Wilson. Nowhere to turn here, and he's going to go down. Back at about the 37-yard line. It looks like a 12-yard loss there on the first down sack. Throwing on second and long. Wilson. He finds Lynch. It's complete. A good gain of 9 before he's brought down at the 28.
And I like the idea here. Get the ball in his hands, even if it's in the passing game. 3 catches a week ago, and he does a nice job here to pick up yardage.
Third and long. It's Wilson. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down. The kick by Lutz is good, and the deficit drops now from 21 down to 18. So, Charles, they are on the board after that kick. So, 3 drives, 3 points, obviously not the start that you were hoping for, but they're able to erase that 0 off the scoreboard.
Yeah, I guess what you're saying is a point of drive is not what offenses are striving for by any stretch. They're happy they've got 3 now. They hope that that unlocks their offense for bigger points down the road.
The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. Right now, everything they touch turns to gold. This is their 4th possession. Touchdowns on their first 3 possessions. I mean, this defense, they can't seem to stop them. It's like they're on skates.
Great analogy, Brandon, because they are pushing them back and winning everything at the line of scrimmage. They've just been laying down tracks towards the opposite end zone. So to themselves, all they're saying is, if we don't make a mistake, there's no way they can stop us.
Here's Favre to throw. And this one is incomplete.
And this drive is almost over before it began, thanks to a great defensive effort. Sack on first down, followed by an
interception. Oh, yeah, so he can't plant his feet.
And they get off the field.
I see it.
He'll drop to throw. And he goes down. It's a sack. They get him back at his own 3-yard line. Brought down by multiple defenders, and it's a loss of 12. Here comes the Lions punter now. And no room for error here as his first punt comes from deep in his own end zone. Now it's Lockett. A big kick there. We'll call it 56 yards on the punt. And it'll be Seahawk football, first and 10. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense.
And this, let's face it, an important drive if they're going to get back into this ballgame.
Think about going into the locker room.
JC, you say you're giving out a 5-year age reduction.
And Wilson's going to be intercepted a third time. And the Lions are going to take possession of the football. A nightmare of a first half for him. And that's now 3 interceptions. But Charles, with his talent, if anyone can shake this off and right the ship, it's him.
I'm going to go ahead and join his league back, man.
Without developing some major mental toughness, so I expect him to go to the locker room at halftime, hit the reset.
And that is cool. I'm about to tell him right now, actually, before it's too late.
A great play there. With 2 touchdowns on the season, both in this game. And the Lions continue to pull away here in this first half. Now they'll line up to kick the extra point. And they open the lead up now to 25 points. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. DJ Dallas to return it from his end zone. And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of 1 there. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. This offense returning out there, and really, you remember the last drive, Charles, it was over before it even began. They threw the interception on the very first play.
And what that means is for all these guys, it's been a while since they've been out there going full speed, so they've got to get everyone back out there, run a couple of your go-to plays. Make sure you get your offense oiled up a little bit. They've got to be able to start fast, but they've got to be efficient as well.
Especially the quarterback.
Hey, get up.
Play action. Now Wilson. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
So far in this drive, they've done some good work. They forced incompletions on first and second down, bring up third and 10. That brings up the big question. Do they bring pressure or do they play coverage on this down?
They go play action now. Wilson. And his pass is intercepted for the 4th time today. Well, that is interception number 4 for him, Charles. 4 here in the first half alone, and they're already trailing by 4 possessions.
Makes me wonder, partner, do they just not have any confidence at all in the backup, or do they just have that much confidence in him? Able to throw 4 picks already, they're certainly hoping that he can turn things around and quickly.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
And to put it mildly, this is a tough spot defensively. They have to come right back out and defend their red zone. But how about that good first step towards forcing them to settle for at least 3 points?
And in for the Lions touchdown. A great effort there. On his way to a monster game, 3 first half touchdowns. And the Lions are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Extra point right down the middle. And a rout is on here in this first half. Here are the Lions now as they line up and kick this one away. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. There was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You can never have enough points with the high-powered offenses that you face. And analytics will tell you, try and score when given the opportunity.
They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete.
I hate to say it, Charles, but the way that he has played in this first half, you just kind of hold your breath every time he drops back to pass.
Yeah, you might be holding your breath with those guys on the defensive side of the ball. They've got big smiles on their faces. He's handing out picks like the people just leave the candy out at Halloween, and you take what you want. They're having a blast out there playing against him today.
That's complete. He's got Lynch out of the backfield. He's got room past the 30, and he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. A real letdown defensively. That was third and a bundle, but they allow the conversion. The big play has him all the way out near midfield for a first and 10. Throwing is Wilson. He's going to launch this thing way downfield. Well, that is now his fifth interception thrown in this game. And Charles, you've got to tip your cap to this defense. I mean, they have been so impressive reading these passes, stepping in those lanes, and picking them off.
Yeah, sometimes the best offense is an excellent defense, and they've done exactly that. What do you think, partner? A season's worth of highlights in just four quarters? I think that's what we're seeing from this group.
But now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
That incompletion certainly slows things down a little bit and brings up a very important call for second and long. What do you do? Run and try and get some yardage and make it third manageable? Or challenge the coverage again?
And the Seahawk defense gets to him and they bring him down. They'll wind up losing 10 on the sack, and it'll lead to a third and long. Now the Seahawks going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 14 seconds to go in this first half.
You talking about JC Lee?
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Under pressure, they got him again. Now a second timeout called for by the defense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. On fourth down, Jack Fox on to punt for Detroit. Returnable for Lockett. That'll go as a 42-yard punt, but a net of 32. They had a 10-yard return, and there'll be time for maybe one final play before halftime. Final play of the half. It's Wilson. He's got a man complete. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. So we've reached halftime here in Detroit with the Lions out on top. As we send you down to Orlando where Jonathan Coachman has our EA Sports halftime report. Coach. And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. The Seahawks trailing, but they will have possession first here as we resume action in the third quarter. Certainly not what they wanted out of the locker room here as they'll start defensively at the 40-yard line. On first and 10, it's Wilson. Over the middle, that's caught by Metcalf. And he's going to be taken down right at the 40-yard line. A lot of ground left to make up, obviously. A lopsided contest, and we're already in the third quarter. And they won't get it all back in one play or one drive. That's cliche, but it's true, Charles. If they can just maybe get plays like that and get a little momentum built, they can get the scoreboard a little closer.
And can you add some blinders to the cliche, meaning keep these guys from looking at the scoreboard because that doesn't help them at all right now. Their focus needs to be on finishing every drive with points and playing mistake-free football from here on out.
Eluding the pressure right. And he'll just get rid of it.
I'm sure it was a tough halftime trying to figure out some strategy to get things going. Trailing by a lot when they went into the locker room. He's just trying every avenue to spark his team here to begin the third quarter. Not a lot going on that play, though.
Wilson. He's got his tight end fan, and he is going to have a Seahawks first down. They needed 5 and 7.
Still in. Hey Ryan, I'm about to join back. Just send me an invite before you drop, if you can. The same one, it's my account.
And he's brought down at the 24 after a gain of 4.
Yep.
6 yards left on second down. Now it's Wilson. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought
damn,
down.
Damn, hopefully I got my nigga still, but.
What an effort from him on that play. Big tackle for a loss of 11. Wilson to the Seahawks looking for something big following the sack. It's third and long here.
After I score one more time, I'm going to ask this nigga to concede.
And my goodness, another interception. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the.
Yeah, I'm about to join right after this game. I'm playing in Bright Legend League.
The reason why this team has struggled to put points on the board so far because too many of their drives.
You said what?
Turnovers already, and we still have almost a full half.
Yeah, I'm about to drive right after I get out the game.
Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive.
I'm enjoying.
The first half definitely went their way, and this would seem to be a great opportunity to kind of put this game a little closer out of reach with a score here.
Yeah, and it's a wonderful opportunity for them because if they can add something more to the
good drive flash, who got right here?
Guys even see the football? That could be the decisive blow in this game. I think that's how they're eyeing it. That's how they're approaching it.
Favre's throw caught by Sanders.
But this nigga Charlie Sanders, hold on, I got to use him more.
Red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. 34 yards to gain that time, another first down.
We're picked up in my top 10 with the Saints pick.
Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. And it's caught.
I'm about to ask him to concede after I put up 42. I ain't tripping if I miss a pick, though.
And they are wasting little time. Oh, they're going to run a little pop pass here. And he's going to take it in for a Lion touchdown.
Yeah, he was.
A great play there. His second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Lions just
keep. Yeah, Guidry's on my team.
Extra point splits the uprights.
Nah, he was, man. Damn, it's like that.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive.
You ain't gonna give me my nigga back, bro.
As this offense takes the field against CD, remember last drive.
He got a trade on him, right?
But then they threw that.
He ain't got a trade on him, then it ain't mine.
We'll see if they can right the ship here on this drive.
And doesn't that just sum up football? We see it all the time.
Don't forget about
the defense goes from losing the battle to making a huge play and stealing the momentum.
He did me dirty, though, and keep my nigga, though.
One more time. And we'll see if the offense is up for that challenge here as things start to get more interesting here in the second half.
And now here's another interception.
It's cool. I'm going to make them pay.
Take possession of the football. Gosh, you add up last week and this week now.
That's
9 interceptions in this 2-game stretch, and we're not done here.
It's almost like they can't even believe their eyes. Or maybe, partner, is the confidence level in him so high that they believe he'll get out of it and make plays for them to win a game?
They said they believe in him. That's being tested right here. Now a throw to the end zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete. So second and 10 now here in the third quarter from Detroit. And they go play action with Favre.
Oh, I did not want to load it.
Traffic, and it's intercepted. And the Seahawks force the turnover. They'll take over at their own 27. Well, with the size of lead that this offense has, I don't think that interception is really going to affect them much. But at least for this defense, something small to hang their hat on.
Yeah, and let's face it, they're not even scoreboard watching anymore, right? They're just trying their best to make a play, get themselves off the field, which they just did, and salvage a little bit of pride in this one.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. Well, we're still in the third quarter, so there's some time to kind of clean this up and make it look more respectable now. A win, that's probably gone out the window, Charles, but I don't know. Do you look at this as a time to just improve and maybe start to look towards the future?
I think you have to find something to play for, something to grasp onto until the clock runs out. But, Brandon, we've been around this game a long time. This is an outlier. You don't get many blowouts like this, no matter how the game looks on paper going in. This one has turned out to be everyone's worst nightmare realized.
On first down, Wilson. And my goodness, another interception. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And he will bring it back. An interception return for the Lions touchdown.
And Charles, for this offense, those interception woes they kind of had in the first half have now followed them into the second half. And for this defense, they take advantage, turn that into a pick six.
And that defense is in a spot now where they're thinking about ways to close this game out. As confidently as they've been playing, I expect them to do exactly that.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away.
And he'll just take a seat, and the drive will begin at the 25-yard line. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. It's a game that they would rather probably forget about, at least to this point, Charles. And one reason is turnovers. The turnover on the last drive, they had the issue in the first half as well, and that's really, unfortunately for them, helped to put this game out of reach.
And you know they won't admit it to themselves, but we know that winning the game is pretty much out of the picture now. So their bottom line is, how do they play a clean game the rest of this one, right? Take care of the football. No more turf.
Got so many memories that I made on Casket Road. I done gained the world. I ain't never sell my soul. This is God-given, so I thank him as I go.
All right, I'm about to join in right now. You said you sent the invite already, Ryan, right? All right, then.
God power from my head and my feet.